Hey everyone, this is Morgan from Switcher CEO with a brief tutorial on how to use Switcher with LiveScale and some of the key features of Switcher for live selling. We'll start off on our LiveScale dashboard, going into the event we want to broadcast to and choosing Other for streaming software in the preview. This process typically takes a minute or two, but not to worry, it's just the system getting ready. I'll show you the whole process, but I've sped it up for everyone's sake. Once the preview is finished, we'll select Other in the video setup section, which gives us a stream URL and stream key. This is what we need to connect Switcher to the LiveScale video player. The simplest way to connect the feed is to go to your Switcher dashboard, dashboard.switcherstudio.com, and logging in with your Switcher credentials. We'll then go to platforms in the sidebar and down to custom RTMB. As you can see, I've got one for LiveScale already. You can see the URL and stream key are the same. We'll go ahead and save that. From here, we'll move to the phone and the Switcher Studio app. There I am. Hello, Morgan. On the Switcher app, we'll use the bottom menu to navigate until we can simply tap on the Outputs tab, the square with the arrow. We'll then see our platforms and the option for custom RTMP. We'll tap on that and select our LiveScale stream, which also has the same info. You want to make sure the information is the same because that's how Switcher and LiveScale will talk to one another. When we're ready, we'll hit the big red button and it'll say live in the top right corner. Like so. Don't worry, it's just going to LiveScale. On LiveScale, we should soon see the video feed populate with our video. Ready? There we are. It's just that easy, and we've got it all connected. One of the key things to be aware of when bringing Switcher into LiveScale is the change in framing from one to another. Here my hands approximate the edge of frame on Switcher's 16:9 horizontal view. And now my hands are indicating LiveScale's 4:3 more square format. It's important to be aware of where your edges are. As we look on LiveScale, we can see my hands out of frame on the video player until, like we saw in the previous view, I move them in to meet the mark that show where the edges were. Best practice is to keep your content centered when you can. Next, we'll look at how to get our logo onto our live stream and using Switcher Cloud for our production assets. We'll start by pressing the blue plus button at the bottom, which brings up the assets field. We can go immediately to the Switcher Cloud option on the bottom right by tapping on it, which will bring up all the eligible assets we have stored in the cloud. However, if we go back for a moment, we can also specifically tap on the logo button to then assign an image to be used as a logo with some pre-established placement, again, still using Switcher Cloud. To see how we're using Switcher Cloud, let's jump back to the dashboard for a moment. If we go to the Switcher Cloud option in the sidebar, it will pull up our full library. If we click the plus icon in the top right, we can add an asset directly from this device by clicking on the box and finding the file or dragging and dropping something into it. As mentioned, we can do this with videos as well, so it's super easy to bring in product or B-roll content for your live stream. As you can see, we've got our Switcher logo in there, so we can go back to our phone. Back in our Switcher app, we tap the Switcher logo and it brings up a properties panel. You can align the logo with these preset buttons like so, then tap, hold, and drag the logo in the view panel to move it exactly where you want. That looks good for our frame. When we've added it, we tap on it in our sources panel and it'll stay on screen for your live stream, which you can also see on here on the LiveScale. Multiviews are one of Switcher's great features, and we're working on making them function even better with LiveScale's format. For now, a great one to use is available in our live selling sample section, found by tapping cards and live selling samples. There's a lot of great choices here for different live selling tools, so I recommend checking them out, but we're looking for our multiview specifically, which features a side-by-side view and title in the middle. Here it is. When tapped on, it brings up some properties and will automatically pre-select your first two camera angles. You can change the lateral positioning of each camera to fit in the square, which is great for our purposes and the format of LiveScale. Let's see, that looks about right. You can change the main and secondary colors to match your brand. Do blue. As well as the corner logo, not so relevant if it's getting cut out. But change the text to match your store name by tapping on it and using the device keyboard like you were writing any other text. Gotta make sure I spell my name right here. When finished, hit done in the top right, and it'll be in the sources panel. Once tapped on, we automatically shift to that view, and it's just that simple. Now that's done, let's look at how we can bring in a remote guest. If we go back to our computer, we can see how the multi-view is looking, very nice, and go back to our switcher dashboard. Once here, we go to remote guests in the sidebar, which shows an invite link and the ability to launch the room. For ease of use, you can tap the copy link button and it'll copy it to your clipboard. If we launch the room, you can see this entry screen, allowing you to enter your name, like so, then choose the camera, microphone, and speakers. Once ready, tap join room and you're in. This is the same view any guest will see, so the experience is universal. Going back to our phone, on Switcher we use our bottom navigation menu to get to the remote guest icon, the two people, and join the room when ready. Any guests in the room will appear in this section. On the computer, this is what the guests will see on their side, with a production preview of the live showing up so that they can follow along in real time. On the app, if we go back to our sources panel, we can now see that remote guest as another camera angle. Tap on it, hello. And again, on the guest side, hello. We can also bring that remote guest into the multi-view by tapping, holding down to edit, then choosing the remote guest for angle A or B. We can then move them side to side where they need to be, and we're good to go. Tap on it, and we've got someone remote ready to talk live selling. Now let's see it also from the live scale view. And there we are, just that easy. Next, let's look at how to use and create titles. Here's one I made earlier with how it looks on Switcher and on live scale. These can be created all in-app in Switcher for both the host and any guests. If we go to our assets menu and tap text and graphics, then lower thirds, we'll find a wide range of templates. I like this top one because I think it's very versatile and clean. As you can see, by tapping, holding, and dragging, we can move it around the frame and use the scale all slider to change the size of the text. We can change the title by tapping on it and typing with the device keyboard. We'll go with something creative like Morgan. Then we can do the same for the subtitle. Again, let's get really creative and do Switcher. That done, let's make sure the size and the position is right. There we have it. Tap on it, and it'll pop up again here on Switcher and how it looks on live scale. If we have two people, there's an easy way to repurpose our titles to fit them. If we tap, hold, and edit, we can change the properties and drag our title over to the right of the screen. That looks good for our frame. We can then tap, hold, and press duplicate to create an exact copy, which we can edit and move to the left of the screen. For clarity's sake, let's call this one Evil Morgan, I guess because it's the clone. Once done and in our sources panel, we tap on both of them and we're titled on Switcher and on live scale, and it's that easy. Finally, let's look at how to bring video into your production. If we go to our assets menu, then tap video, we can use a video stored on the device or from Switcher Cloud. Let's use Switcher Cloud for this example. I have this sample video here, so we'll use that. Tapping it will bring up the video properties. We can let it play full screen, but because of its format, we might cut off the edges. So we can tap the custom framing button on the end, the finger, and tap, hold, and drag to move it around. Use the alignment buttons or pinch in and out to change the size, like so. When it looks right, tap done and it'll appear in your sources panel. Simply tap on it for autoplay. As a word of caution, the video won't loop, so if you want to play it again, you have to tap it off and then on again once more. We can see it going here in the Switcher live view, and then here on live scale. It's great to use this as an intro video by simply tapping on your camera when you want to switch, like so. Thanks so much, everyone. Hope this helps. Happy streaming.